The annual excitement that is the release of hitherto classified documents from the National Archives is upon us. This year an unusually high number have been withheld by the Cabinet Office. The reason given for continued secrecy is, of course, national security. When, I think we are all asking ourselves, is someone going to start tackling the problem of national insecurity, which is endemic? The main thing we have learned from this year's cache is that Margaret Thatcher is indeed very much the person we thought she was. Having been defenestrated as Prime Minister by her erstwhile protege, John Major, Thatcher at first assumed she would be able to continue bossing him about as the power behind the throne. Major appears to have disabused her with some alacrity, using the fiendish strategy he seems to have applied to all things, not taking her too seriously. Major's notes on national and international affairs are rather endearing. A 1992 coup attempt against Russian President Boris Yeltsin was greeted with, "Illegal coup. Can't put the clock back." An attempt by the London School of Economics to annex County Hall in another illegal coup was quelled with a simple, "Barry. Hang on." Annoyingly, however, it seems that Major's laid-back strategy was wrong. National insecurity, among Guardian types anyway, has been given a good old stir with the news that Thatcher was definitely right about a number of issues. Dang. Thatcher was right about the exchange rate mechanism, warning Major that his economic plans would lead to disastrously high interest rates. I remember being a bit bitter about the 15% rate on my mortgage, as I was understandably ignorant of the fact that I was still part of the lucky generation. Thatcher was right about pandas, believing they were bad omens and refusing to share a plane with one, presumably in the prescient knowledge that before long there would be more pandas in Scotland than Tory MPs. And she was right about television licenses, arguing passionately that non-payers should not be criminalised. It's worth noting that some of Major's ideas, which sank without trace at the time, did get taken up much later. The licence thing is one of those examples of left and right achieving harmony, despite opposing motivations. Thatcher wanted decriminalisation both because the alternative aggrandised the BBC far too much for her taste, and because she preferred the state's power to be limited whenever possible. But 1 in 10 prosecutions in England and Wales are for non-payment of licence fees, and people, often women, still go to prison for the crime. Cheeringly, however, the Cabinet papers do confirm that the Conservative Party came to view Thatcher as irredeemably toxic, which is something they now like to pretend was never true. There was much worry over what to do during the 1992 general election, what with Thatcher not quite realizing that she had become voter hemlock. She could certainly not be allowed to appear at the final rally. Chris Patten, then chairman of the party, was charged with gently breaking this to her, explaining that the rally should be as forward-looking as possible. Also, Thatcher was furious that Major was ditching the poll tax, somehow having missed the fact that she had been deposed precisely so that the poll tax could be ditched.